The year is 1954. NBC had come to New Orleans for Mardi Gras. WDSU provided the cameras, and NBC's Merrill Muller provided the commentary.
Get a load of that crowd in St. Charles Street. St. Charles Avenue, one of the finest and most beautiful in the city, and this is a city of beautiful avenues and beautiful homes. St. Charles Avenue is absolutely packed all the way from Lee Circle out as far as I can see behind me here.
NBC had never seen anything like this before, and neither had America, except for those who had visited New Orleans.
There goes the ladder now.
In those days, we didn't have all the sophisticated equipment we now take for granted. Director Paul Yosich remembers that he couldn't even communicate with his cameraman on the street.
But my cameraman knew what shots I wanted, and I couldn't tell him anything, so I waited for them to get a shot, and I'd punch it up.
Yosich remembers what it was like in those early days, and what a treat WDSU was giving its viewers. And our live coverage did not end on the street. WDSU had live cameras inside the Municipal Auditorium to give the nation its first ever look at the elite world of carnival royalty at the Rex Ball and the meeting of the courts of Rex and Comus.
Gaines Batson, our announcer, who was with WDSU in radio, moved over into television, was the narrator, and he had a very stiff, old-time announcer voice. He would say, "Now the Queen of Rex joins the King." And the same words were used every year.
And now we see the King and Queen rising as Phoebe Williams and Leon Irwin Jr. There's the scepter gesture for everyone. And everybody in the ballroom is now clapping. The Queen's mantle, which you can get a look at, is 7 yards long and weighs 40 pounds.
Rex that year was Leon Irwin Jr., a prominent insurance executive. And his queen was a lovely ballet dancer, Phoebe Williams.
This particular queen, Phoebe Williams, is studying at the Metropolitan Opera Ballet School in New York. And that is what she wants to be, a ballet dancer. But tonight she is a queen. And the queen, despite her ballet studying, is a real Southern belle. Make no mistake about it. "I have no hobbies except a little sewing," she told me. "And I don't know how to drive a car." I asked her if she could cook. "I can," she said, "but I don't."
Leon Irwin is now retired, and his queen passed away some years ago. But this was their night, reigning supreme all those years ago. And who knows what the viewers of America thought of this strange ritual we call Mardi Gras. But Mardi Gras is our day here at Channel 6, and we have never missed it.
This is a wonderful, gay, charming evening tonight. In the olden days of Mardi Gras, Rex used to go to Comus Ball to steal a queen. Later in 1880...
We have also never missed the changing of the guard at City Hall. This is 1974, Moon Landrieu being sworn in for his second term as mayor.
"Today is the first day of the rest of our lives."
Former newspaper woman Iris Kelso covered the story for Channel 6.
Iris Kelso with Channelman Bob Perrin, Newswatch 6.
WDSU turned its sights on newspaper people like Iris Kelso for its early reporting staff. She was a 20-something right out of college when she went to work for the newspaper. In 1967, she signed on for 11 years with WDSU-TV. Later, she returned to the Picayune, from which she is now retired.
Hello.
Other than news, Iris Kelso loves the garden of her uptown home, even in these winter months. It's the view she sees from her computer keyboard, where she is assembling her memoirs for a book. Memories of 1959, when she staked out a Covington motel where Governor Earl Long was hiding out.
"We sat outside and watched things, people come and go. One day we saw Blaze Starr, the strip teacher, the teaser that he was probably having an affair with, come and go."
Iris Kelso. She gave WDSU-TV 11 of its 50 years, helping us become what we are today, Louisiana's most authoritative news voice.
"Good evening, my dear friends of science, students, and of course, those of the higher order."
And how can we remember our 50 years without remembering Morgus the Magnificent? Who was Morgus, and what's he up to now? We'll answer that question when we continue with this special report on the golden anniversary of WDSU-TV.